Haley Abrams, and coming at you live from Spain. This time we're down here in the bottom peak of Europe, right there, as you can see. And we're going to be talking about something that happened a while back, but is really prevalent now. The card bomb that Anise Del Rio's unit of ETA, a Basque separatist group, planted in Madrid's Dominican Republic Square killed 10 people. They were not the only victims of Ms. Del Rio's unit, though. The list includes 13 others, targets or passerbys. One, even an American executive, Eugene Brown, visiting Madrid on business. Like all Spanish murderers found guilty at trial, Del Rio was sent to jail. There is no life term or death sentence in Spain, though. Her sentences total 3,828 years, but ran simultaneously, with the law agreeing to a maximum sentence of 30 years. Her release, including further decreases for good behavior, was due after 21 years in 2008. But a new understanding of the law, first introduced for ETA members, took away the years for good behavior, postponing her release until 2017. However, on October 21st, the European Court of Human Rights, or ECHR, in Strasbourg, declared this understanding to be illegal. Ms. Del Rio was freed the following day, October 22nd. That is not the end of the matter. 53 other ETA members responsible for dozens of killings must be released too, as well as other terrorists, including one from a state-backed dirty war group that attacked ETA targets in the 1980s. A dozen rapists and murderers will also go free. In all, more than 70 of Spain's most violent prisoners should be released as the country's courts support their appeals. Mariano Rajoy's conservative popular party government has fought the ECHR all the way. It takes a rigidly left line on ETA and has accused previous left-leaning governments of going easy on terrorism. Now, Mr. Rajoy is in a dilemma. He has previously marched alongside influential victims groups that are loudly and angrily backed by the right-wing press, and they are calling on him to refuse to obey the ECHR ruling. Since Britain overlooked an ECHR order in 2005 to give voting rights to prisoners, the argument goes, Spain can also ignore the Strasbourg court. Mr. Rajoy has remained silent, leading ministers to explain that there is little choice but to allow the courts to release the prisoners. However, on October 23rd, he met victims groups who were planning a protest to reassure them that there would be no sudden mass release. In fact, ETA's aging prisoners are less of a danger than the rapists and murderers who will also be set free. A weakened EGA declared a one-sided and permanent truce in October 2011. Although this was not the case with previous truces, it has stuck to this one. The group is yet to hand over its arms. The release of prisoners would smooth the path towards such an event. Many in the Basque area, including the regional government of the modern Basque national leader, Iñigo Urkullu, believed it is time to complete the peace process. The government has a chance to do what it has failed to do in 2 years, become an active agent for peace, says Fernando Barena of SORTU, an increasingly powerful separatist movement. They would like to see a softer approach to ETA's 600 remaining prisoners, many of whom are kept in prisons hundreds of miles from their families. But Mr. Rajoy has done nothing beyond promising that the security forces' full strength will fall on the ETA if it returns to arms. ETA negotiators were rejected from Norway when disarmament failed to happen earlier this year. The victims' groups now stirring, Mr. Rajoy is unlikely to move soon. ETA, once more, must act alone. That's all I have on this story. Haley Abrahamson reporting from Spain. Back y'all in the studio.